Hello friends, in this tutorial I'm going to talk about how to set up TSA on HADR database and VIP address. While this video is continuation or the extension of the previous video, so what I will not do is I will not explain how to set up TSA for HADR, but what we will learn is we will learn how to set up the VIP address. So what is a VIP address? VIP stands for virtual IP. So what do you mean by virtual IP? So, you know, we have, whenever we have a primary and a standby, then we need to, wherever the primary is there, we need to connect our database to that particular primary server. Now, if the primary from that server moves to the another server, then we need to disconnect from that particular server and reconnect to new server. So the VIP concept is virtual IP concept. What it allows us to do is the VIP will point to the server which is always the primary. So this is what is my configuration. So I got, what I've done already is I've got two nodes, DB3 and DB4. I got DB2 installed on both the nodes with 10.5 FP5 and HADR is active on the HADB database. So I'll just show you that. So let me clear the screen here. So if you can see, this is my DB3 and this is my DB4. So what I'll do is I will show you HADR get status. So this will be a primary. DB3 is primary and this one DB4 is standby. So this is primary peer connected and this is standby peer connected. So I already have got HADR up and running. And if I show you LSM, then you see I do not have TSA MP setup. So I do not have TSA MP setup. Now, what we need to do is we need to first set up the TSA, and as part of setting up the TSA, I'll also be setting up the virtual IP, the VIP, as we call it. Now, the thing is, the way it works is to set up the TSA, we will use this particular command db2-f and the file name.xml. So we will run db2-haiku on standby first, and then we will initiate that on a primary. Now, Now, remember that the file on the standby and primary is same except the remote hand host and local host in case of the HADR database. So what I have got is I got DB3 with 103. So that is my DB3. I got So I got 104 for DB4, so I got this IP, and I got 1.100. This is the virtual IP. So this particular IP will point to DB3 if DB3 is primary. This particular IP will point to DB4 if DB4 is primary. So wherever the primary database is there, that's where the VIP will point to. How to do that is pretty simple. So we will set up the VIP in our file as part of db2-haiku. So let's see the file, how it looks like. So let me clear the screen and I'll show you here. I will do cat db2-hadr, this particular file. So now I'll maximize the screen. Okay, and I'll do this once again. So what we are saying is we are going to create this domain with a network as quorum device. And we are adding these two IPs. You see, 103 is DB3, 104 is DB4. And everything, the two cluster nodes are DB3 and DB4. I'm adding this instance and I'm adding this particular database. And in this particular section, I'm specifying the virtual IP address. I'm specifying this is the base address, this is a subnet mask, and the network name, I'm adding it to the DB2 private network. So that's what I'm doing. So this particular file, if I show you this particular file on the other node, then this is exactly same file except for the fact that this particular section is different. So this particular file is entire content. So let me clear this for you. And if okay, so this particular file is top to bottom same in both the nodes except for the fact that this particular line varies, where here local host is DB3 and remote host is DB4. Over there, the local host will be DB4 and remote host will be DB3. Rest all, this file will exactly look same on both the nodes. Remember, we will have to run db2-haiku on standby first, followed by primary. So I will show you this particular file on standby. So here local host is DB3, over there, so let me clear the screen, let me maximize the screen, and let me, okay, so here the local host is db4 because this particular file belongs to db4 and this particular line. So this is the line which will set up the VIP, virtual IP. And as I said, the virtual IP will point to db3 if db3 holds primary. Virtual IP will point to db4 if db4 holds the primary. So right now the db3 holds the primary. So let me prove that point to you. So db3 holds the primary. So this particular database holds the primary. So when I set up VIP, so VIP, then that VIP is going to point to db3. Now let's get started. So we have to run this on standby. So we have to run the db2 haiku on standby first. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to prove that this is standby. Okay, so this is the standby. So what I'll do, I'll run the db2 haiku utility. So I'm running this particular utility and I'm doing this on my standby first. So this is my standby. So I'm doing this on standby first. So what it's going to do exactly same, but at the end it's going to set up one VIP. Now we will be able to see VIP only when we do this on both the nodes. So let's wait for this to get completed. Once we do this on standby, I will execute the same command on primary. First domain, then quorum, then the Ethernet ports or IPs, and then the instance, and then finally the database, followed by the VIP. Domain, quorum, Ethernet ports, instance, and the database. I copied this command, so I will run exactly same command on here on primary once I'm done with the standby. That's done. Then the IPs, then the partition, the instance. Okay, so all cluster configurations have been completed successfully. Now we will run. So this was on standby, so on DB4. So I have now set up this particular command. So now I'm going to run the same command on primary. It's going to do exactly same here as well, but IP it will not be able to add because that's already been added. Rest all it will complete successfully. Now, give it a minute. So database has been added and everything looks to be fine. So now what I will do, okay, so if you see here, okay, let me clear the screen and do LSM again. So if you see here, we have got this service IP And on DB3 it is online, while on DB4 it is offline. The reason why it is online on DB3 is because the DB4 is holding the standby database. So the DB4 is holding the standby database. So on DB4, so current host is DB4, and on DB4 it is standby, and hence the VIP, the service IP, is right now it is not pointing to my DB4, it is pointing to DB3. So what I will do now is I will come back here and I will show you if there are any applications which are connected. Absolutely no applications. What I'll do is I will launch command window on my local Windows box. I'm going to catalog the IP, and this time I'm going to use this particular IP, and this is the IP that we used, the 1.100 into our virtual IP. So we can see that 192.168.1.100. So that's our virtual IP. So what I'm saying, catalog TCP IP node as VIP, remote this and server is this, and then I'm going to catalog this particular database DB HADB at that particular node. So that's what I'm doing. So uncatalog, if it is already been done, that's let's uncatalog and let's catalog, and then once that is done, I'm going to connect to that particular database. So right now no applications. Come to Windows and okay, why did I run cmd? I should run db2 cmd. Okay, so let me, yeah, okay, right. So I have now connected to this HADB. Let's run this DB2 list applications again, and you see there is a connection coming from 192.168.1.119, and that's the IP of my Windows box. Okay, so what I'll do, I will show you DB2 get connection state, which will show that I'm connected to 1.100. So I'm connected to this 1.100, and this 1.100 is actually a virtual IP 1.100, and you see my DB2 list application is on DB3. If I run DB2 list applications, it will not show me anything. So if I do it here on DB4, it will not show me anything, because why? My virtual IP is pointing to DB3, which means when I connected to a database, my connection was routed to DB3. So right now I am on DB3, and my connection, the Windows connection using DB2 CMD went to this particular DB3 host. Now what I will do is I will show you that this is my Windows connection. How I will prove that? So what I'll do is I can do DB2 terminate and that connection will go, but instead of that I will show you the IP of my Windows box, and you see I got 1.119. so that's the IP I have got. So that 192.168.119, that's the IP, and that IP got connected to my my Linux DB2 on DB3. So that it got connected on DB3. Now what I will do is I will terminate this particular session. And if I do DB2 list application, that connection will not be there. What I will do now, I will currently, it shows, LSM shows that VIP is pointing to DB3. On DB3, VIP is online, and on DB4, my VIP or service IP is offline. So let me do the takeover. So let me make DB4 as primary. I've done the takeover. Now let me show you that this is my primary. So this is my primary, and let me run LSM again, and you see now I got DB3 offline and DB4 online. So now the VIP is pointing to DB4. So previously VIP was pointing to the whip was pointing to, so here the whip was pointing to DB3 and now the whip is pointing to DB4. The reason why whip started pointing to DB4 is because this became the primary, or DB4 became the primary. Now when I initiate the connection, now I'll initiate the connection back, and if I do DB2 list application, that connection is going to come on this particular node. You see, that connection has come on DB4. And if I do DB2 list application here, then it is shows that there is no connection. So the whip moves. The whip moves from the. So this is how the it works. So the whip which we have configured 1.100 will point to DB3 if DB3 host primary, will point to DB4 if the DB4 host the primary. And the beauty of this solution is no need to connect to different IP addresses. So we don't need to know what is primary server IP. We do not need to know what is the secondary standby IP. One virtual IP can connect to primary database wherever it is, whichever host it is, wherever it is primary, it will be able to connect to that particular host. Now that we have learned this, the way I have done this is using the db2 haiku command, db2 haicu command, and only thing that needs to be done in that particular file, which I will show you to you here again, is what we need to do is we need to add, okay, let's not do this here. So the way I have done it, this particular file is exactly same file that I used in the previous lesson. Only thing that I added is this particular line. I added this particular line, and here I said my whip is 192.168.1.100 on this particular subnet mask, and I'm going to add it to this particular network resource group. So once I add that, then this particular IP moves to my primary server. Wherever my primary database is there, it will move to that particular server. I hope this tutorial was useful. Thanks for watching. Do pass in your comments, and see you in the next tutorial. Thank you. Bye bye.